Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with some more Let's Play This Here Dark Souls 2 Scholar of the First Sin on that there PC. Yes, it has been quite some time since last we were here in the Forest of Fallen Giants. However, due to plot reasons, we are forced to return, because we must now venture in to, well, let's fucking kill this asshole, so he'll stop. Yeah, give me a goer. But we must now venture forth, indeed, into the minds of giants, into the memories of ancient and dead giants. By using the Ashen Mist Heart, we must find these horrible husks and basically wander into them. Now, I will need to remind myself of where they all are, but I believe I do know where at least three of them are. I know that this one's here, I know that there's one just after where we fought the Pursuer boss fight, and then there is another one. Where is the other one? I don't know where the other one is. No, I do know. It's just in a slightly awkward place that I can't remember the name of, but I know how to get there. It's that place for the Turtle Knights and Armorer Dennis. That area. He's near a bonfire. But yes, we need to travel into the memories of giants and claim souls. Oh my, hello. My, you take a lot less damage than the giants I fought before. But at the very least, you did punch a hole through the wall, which means I roughly know where I'm going. Hello! My, you're ugly. Okay, so you take less damage, but you still dish out about as much. Holy shit. Okay. What? I have no idea what you just did, mate, but whatever it did, it left you arse over tea kettle. So it wins in my books. It makes life easier for me. You, sir? Okay, I was gonna say, you look like some form of wizard. I suppose that, well, it looks like you giants are simplistic people. So I guess spitting into your hand is about as close as you guys get to wizards, then. Let's quickly actually just equip all of our healing items. And then, of course, the Aged Feather. Yeah, maybe that's why enemies stop dropping homeward bones after a certain point. I suppose when you know that the player is just going to be able to do that same function without needing a consumable item after a certain point, like, what's the reason in continuing to provide it? Okay, well, you guys seem to have... You seem to have this well in hand. You don't need me here, cramping your style. No, you don't need me here. Ruining it for everyone. You can just continue your little war. Gotta be blunt with you, I'm not actually involved in your little war. Oh, hello. Oh, well, I should probably actually, yeah. No. Okay, so I may have just involved myself a tiny bit in your little war. But I'm not trying to get involved in your little war. Also, okay, good, they aren't firing at me. I can't imagine why they would fire at me. I mean, they're fighting a war against giants, and I'm pretty obviously not with the giants. Yeah, honestly, I'm just kind of here. I look like a scavenger who turned up to the battle a bit too early, so the fight's still going on. You know, I was here to steal from the dead, but unfortunately, the dead are currently still alive. Well, actually, having said that. Everyone involved in what's currently going on has at this point been dead for quite a long time. Are you the giant I need to kill, or are you just the giant that's in my way? Okay, I think you're just the giant that's in my way. Examine. Ah, I got the soul of the giant. Okay, that was the giant that I was looking for. I didn't actually need to kill that giant. Makes me feel a bit bad, actually, the fact that I didn't need to kill him. And I'll just give it one of them. Okay, now let's go and claim the soul of the giant near the pursuer. Piss off. Go have a bit of a bash. Also, yes, it did just occur to me that I should have probably rested at that bonfire. But frankly, I don't really need to all that much. I mean, I've got 6 Estus flasks and almost all of my health. We'll be fine. We'll be perfectly fine. It also just occurred to me that this giant memory I'm about to walk into might be one that's got a boss. Because yes, one of the giant memories does actually contain a boss fight. It may very well be that there is only one giant memory you are required to enter, and it may very well be the one with the boss fight. But I'm gonna go into all the ones I can remember regardless. Because I can. Memory of Aura. What the fuck? Why are you attacking me? I'm a good guy here. I say good guy, I don't actually know if there are good guys. Strange that the common soldiery still look and act like they're hollow. Then again, I suppose they are only base creatures. The common soldier. Don't know what you do! Oh, you reveal this. Whoops. Regret ahead. Illusion ahead. Okay, let's activate the other Pharos Lockstone. Ah, I see why that was regret. Steel armor? Okay. Got a suit of armor, which I'm never gonna wear. Cool. And a fire seed. Okay, great, nothing of importance. Moving on! It is weird when you realize you're walking through someone else's memories. It does beg the question as to how we're taking stuff out of here, though. Doesn't it? It can't just be me who's wondering that. Like, what are those, like, what friggin' physical laws is it that are requiring that are, oh, fuck me. That are enabling me, not requiring me. But what physical laws are that are allowing me to like take things out of people's memories? Do you know what I mean? Ow! Ow, you bastard. But no, but like, how can you... Like, souls are kind of ephemeral. Do you know what I mean? And I can kind of see how I'd be taking the soul out of something's memory, because it's not so much that I'm taking the soul out of their memory, as much as it is that I'm accessing the soul that's in their body via their memory. Like, that's at least how I'm explaining it to myself. That's how I'm making sense of it in my own head. But how is it that I'm accessing... How have I taken armor out of something's memory? Do you know what I mean? Like, it's like, how is this even slightly physically possible? Also, a dark spirit invasion right now. Oh, you shouldn't have. And I mean that quite literally. You really shouldn't have. I could have done without another fucking dark spirit invasion. Just given the fact that you appear to have... Just given the fact that you appear to be caught on the fucking wall there, mate. Damn it. There you go. Eat some backstab, friend. Ow. Please stop that. I have done nothing to you. Who are you? Why do you hate me? These questions and many more. Lurk within my mind as you invade my bloody universe. Who are you, Forlorn? I'm pretty sure you're one of the NPC invaders who invades the same, who will invade, like, the player frequently. And yet I still have no idea why. Are you just a dick? Is that it? Are you just a dick? I think he might just be a dick. I think that might be the only reason he invades. What? Forlorn, why do you invade? That's because I'm a dick, innit? Okay, let's wander our way back into the fucking soul of a monster again. I say a monster. The giants aren't necessarily monsters. I mean, they're weird. Like, they're really bloody odd, but that doesn't make them bad. It makes them odd. Makes them deeply fucking odd. Weirdly shaped bodies as well. Like, the point at which I just kind of prefer not thinking about their physiology. Their physiology creeps me the fuck out. Go away. Oh, don't mind me. I really don't know why I'm here. I'm thinking maybe I was supposed to go downstairs, not upstairs. Let's go down. Let's try downstairs. Hi, don't mind me. There's a giant upstairs that you should really be a lot more concerned about than you should be with, like, one ugly guy running around. Drop in from the sky. Am I going mad, or did he just drop in from the sky? Ah, lovely. Okay. Grabbed your soul as well. And now I just need to... Now I just need to go get my hands on the one that is in the turtle room, or in the turtle area, the area full of turtles. Rest at the bonfire, get me Esther Spark back and such. And now let's go have a bit of a run. Because I don't actually need to engage with any of the enemies on the way. And honestly, there's no real need to. I mean, I don't know, I might fight Armorer Dennis just to get rid of him when he attacks me again. Hi, Skelling Bones. Actually, I'm pretty sure most of the enemies in this area, I'm pretty sure I just, like... Yeah. Yeah, they're nothing. Because, yeah, at this point. Because, yeah... Going back to an area you're supposed to play at the beginning of the game. After you've beaten the DLC. Grossly overleveled. Grossly. I mean, that's not to say that you can't still die. You could definitely still die. I don't think there's any point in a Dark Souls game when the enemies become not a threat. Become so comparatively powerless that you just don't need to worry about them anymore. Because, you know, that Turtle Knight hitting me would still do a fuckload of damage. Do you know what I mean? Right, Armorer Dennis, where are you? Ah, there you are, Dennis. How are you? It's been a while since you last made an attempt on my life. Actually, no, it's not been that long, because I think you made another attempt on my life in the Iron Keep, didn't you? I think you did, anyway. I can't recall. I know someone did. Oh, it's so entertaining coming back to an area that we are entirely too good for. Okay, what did we just get? We just got leather armor, I think, didn't we? Yeah, I think we're gonna stay with our tattered robes, honestly. I like me tattered robes. Am I misremembering something? Because I'm fairly... Oh, yeah, no, I'm not misremembering anything. A giant rests in peace. What the fuck, the giant seed? A giant rests in peace. Okay, well... Good for him, I guess, but... I was kind of hoping that I'd get to go, you know, enter his soul. A giant rests in peace. Okay, I guess we just don't fight that one? Oh, we don't go into that one's memory? Ah, oh, can't use the bonfire because he's too close. Go away. Thank you. Huh. That's rather odd, because I know there's at least one more. Huh. Where could the last one actually be? So I'm gonna look this up, because... Okay, there's... I want to know where the Giant Lord is the main thing. because he's an actual boss that we can fight. Oh. Okay. I thought the other one was there. Okay, we need to go open up a door. And while I'm loading in there, I'm going to be deeply unprofessional and feed my cat. Because she is going to be bloody irritating unless I feed her right now, and I can't be bothered pausing or stopping the video and starting again. Because it's a bit of a faff on. So, you all get to hear me shouting from across the room as I fill my bowl full of cat food. Because yes, I feed my cat in my room because the other cat hates her and will steal her food. So we have to feed one of them in my room. Okay, back in the chair, headphones on, controller in hand. Let's go fight some fuckers. Where is the king's door? Oh no, wait, no, I remember. Yeah, I remember, it's over there. Yep. Nope. Produce the symbol of the king. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm wearing the friggin' ring. Open up. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, 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 way! We have a bonfire. I have no idea why there's a bonfire there, I'm not gonna lie. Never known, because I don't believe there's any enemies in this area, as far as I recall. Yeah, no, it's just the giant memory. Yeah, yeah, it's just the giant. So I don't know why we'd need a bonfire here. Because it's also not that far away from a bonfire already. But then again, Dark Souls 2 has some odd bonfire placement. Does Dark Souls 2. Very good. Until we meet the giant lord. Ow! Who's a big horrible, whose moveset I do not know. But hopefully he shouldn't be too difficult to deal with. It's seeming to me, even already, that he's going to suffer from the same problem that oh so many big enemies have suffered from. That problem being that they don't really have, yeah, much of an answer for the ankle biters. I cannot believe how much easier so many of the fucking bosses in this game are if you are small. Like, I cannot believe it. It is truly mind-blowing. Okay, well, I think we actually just got the only necessary item from that whole thing. The giant's kinship, because that's what we need in order to access the throne of want. The throne of want being the ultimate goal of the game, really. Okay, so we got another soul of a giant, which means we have 3, 4 if we include 4 if we include the one that's in that we've got contained within a bonfire. 5 if we went to kill the five if we went and killed the ancient dragon, which we aren't doing. There is, however, one more place we need to go. Before we can move on to wherever we need to go next, and I'm genuinely not sure. And that is, I want to go and deal with King Vendrick. Because in order to access King Vendrick prior to him being an absolute ruin of a creature, in order to access him and, I believe, sort out the stuff with crowns and such, we needed the Ashen Heart thing that allowed us to access the giant memories, which I believe will allow us to access the memory of Vendrick in much the same way. Though we may have to fight Hollow Vendrick in order to access it. But we have 4 of the 5 giant memories, so it shouldn't be that hard. I don't actually know if he's going to be hostile to us when we enter. Are you? Yes, he is. Yep, he is hostile to us. Very slow, though, and it looks like we are going to actually have to kill Hollow Vendrick in order to access non-Hollow Vendrick. However, I believe we have already observed the complete extent of his moveset. This is all he can do. Poor soul. This might take a while. So, how are you? Doing good? I'm doing pretty good myself, must be said. Feeling a bit shitty today, but granted that's because I didn't get to sleep until, like, stupid o'clock at night. Oh my, you actually did a different kind of attack. Genuinely quite impressed, Vendrick. I thought that sort of thing was beyond you. Oh my god, You moved at, like, some kind of speed for a split second there. I'm gonna have to wonder why he took his clothes off, though. Do you know what I mean? Him being hollow and just kind of wandering around like a madman, that's one thing, but doing it in his undercrackers, you know what I mean? I don't know. Okay, I am apparently an idiot because I have forgotten how to avoid that swing. There's a much easier way to avoid it. Stay behind Vendrick. They basically just can't hit you. Yeah, stay behind Vendrick. But no, yeah, like, going hollow and just kind of being a bit of a shit, kind of wandering, you know, walking around in circles. That's one thing. But removing every stitch of clothing except for your crown, that and like your undergarments, that's a different thing. Okay, good, dead Mandrake. Do you feel like a boss killer? Because I don't. Did we get his soul? No, we didn't get Vendrick's soul. Presumably because he's already gone hollow. And yeah, here we go. Into the mind of Vendrick. Or rather, into the memory of his armor. Yeah, the memory of the king. Hello, Vendrick.
Seeker of fire, coveter of the throne, I am Vendrick, ruler of Dranglake.
You're also dead, mate.
Seeker of fire, deliverer of crowns. What do you see in the flames? Find the crowns and your own answers.
I've already got the crowns. Crowns
hold the strength of lords from times long past.
I already got all three of them.
Seek adversity, as befits you, seeker of fire. Coveter of the throne. Seeker of fire, conqueror of dark. I too sought fire once. With fire, they say, a true king can harness the curse. A lie, but I knew no better. Seeker of fire, you know not the depth of dark within you. It grows deeper still, the more flame you covet. Flame, oh, flame. Seeker of fire, I see you've subdued another foul creature. One of the Father of the Abyss spawn. That confounded quintessence of humanity. The Abyss once had form, but then dissipated. And yet, traces of its existence endured. Each fragment, thirsting for power, spread dark with no relent. My dear Chandra was one such fragment. A feeble, tiny thing that thirsted for power more than any other. Driven by insatiable lust for a worthy vessel.
Sorry, I've never actually heard this dialogue, sir.
Fire came to be, and with it, disparity. Heat and cold, life and death, light and dark. Dark was seen as a curse. Shadow is not cast, but born of fire. And the brighter the flame, the deeper the shadow. Inherit fire and harness the dark. Such is the calling of a true leader. Dark was seen, shadow, and the... Such... Dark... Inherit... Such...
So... Okay, so I do have all of the crowns. But I don't actually know what to do with him now that I'm here. You know what? I'm gonna actually end the video here, and in the next episode, we shall see. But that's gonna have to be all for me for now. I've been your host, and as always, keep calm, carry on, good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that, I could have been having a terrible day when I made this video. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. All the same, if you're interested in seeing some live streaming stuff from me, if you look in the description, there'll be a link to my Twitch page, as well as a link to my Twitter in case you want to keep up with all the random gibberish I spew throughout the week. And if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always donate to my Patreon campaign, also linked in the description. Well, that's all from me. This video's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the sideways thinker. Do not seek the pardoner.